Okay, so if we put this together with this.
Yes, the game is on. Now, talk to us, account book. Tell us everything.
Frank's clues.
Let's see if I can find any deal Frank made with Nathan or the Vortex Club. Okay, Max. Remember these names and see how Nathan fits in with all this.
Okay, well, Nathan is Rot. Bulldog is Chloe. Chihuahua is Katie. Stifler? What? Tonks? Okay, so we got Rot, Bulldog, and Chihuahua.
Frank sure is keeping his customers satisfied. He could open a store.
There's Chloe Bulldog with the $3,000 loan. Yeah, it can be easier if I just go like this. Rot, 3 gigs. That's Nathan.
Everybody in Arcadia Bay must be high. That explains a lot.
That's Katie. Is that Kate Marsh? Gas station, 3 sheets, blue sunshine acid.
If Frank applied this kind of detail to his life, who am I to talk?
Katie again. 1/4 pound of green dream.
Two deals with Nathan on the same day? Party supplies, no doubt.
Firebud plus 5 grams speed and 5 grams of cocaine and 5 grams of GHB. It's gotta be a different Kate.
I'm getting a contact high just reading this.
Sure. Really into dogs.
I wonder what dog name Frank would have given me.
All right. Rot, 2 grams of cocaine. 2 sheets of skidoo acid. And 2 grams of molly and 1/4 pound of weed. There's a lot going on this day. So I gotta put stuff together. This. Am I just supposed to put all the rot ones together?
Oh. Oh yes, These are all the times and places for Frank and Nathan's deals. That's it, Max.
Okay, so that's done. David's clues.
Great. Now, how do I find out which car is Nathan's to match the coordinates? Of course Nathan drives an SUV. Overcompensating, as usual.
Surprised it's not a Porsche or something.
There's Nathan dealing to the kids right out in the open. I'm glad Warren got his revenge.
Warren's revenge.
That's definitely Chloe's car. Interesting. Is this Nathan's car?
It's a 4x4 SUV. Sure, it's the same color.
Wow, sir.
Looks like it.
This looks like an expensive machine. Who does this car belong to?
Sex offender? Tape on the taillight. I see it. Tape on the taillight. Not this one. There's no tape, unless it's from before the taillight was hit.
Okay, let's find out whose car this is.
Sex offender? Oh, it's his. Huh? I already know what I can put together.
Why the hell are you following these people? And to where? Yep, another car David was tracking.
It's Chloe's. Twin Peaks. Okay, so I think we're gonna put... Nope, it's not it. Okay. Select. Goes with this. And this.
Oh yes, now we're finally getting somewhere. Chloe, let's plug in these numbers and see if they lead to an actual address.
Aye aye, Captain. Here we come, Rachel.
Got some clues you didn't put together yet. Yeah, Nathan's clues.
Chloe's on a roll to find more clues about Rachel now that we're so close.
Hey, Max. See if you can put together all those Rubik's clues. Just holla if you need any info while I go online to make sure we haven't missed anything.
Alright. Now, what am I supposed to be putting together here? Oh, clues for the info of the phone? I don't know what I'm doing here.
Okay, Max. Let's blow this code up and go home.
Nathan? Get ready to freaking die, bitches. You mess up my dorm. I kill your scholarship. You are great at grammar, let me tell you that much. I'm about to blow you wide open here.
Let's start hacking.
It's just gathering it and... Oh. Isn't unlock the same thing? Okay, apply.
Oops. Bad code.
Okay, circled is 9535. Oh, I keep clicking. Okay.
Yeah, I knew it wouldn't be that easy. You locked it, dumbass.
What? Hold on. PUK. Eight, seven, eight, nine, seven, 808. I don't know if we can use our rewind power. Notice we're using a rewind power a lot less in this episode. 8789 7808. Okay. Yeah, he changed it, alright. Pin code.
Let's find out what Nathan Prescott has been trying to hide.
Cool. I thought... Oh, she's talking about him? I thought we locked it. I thought by hitting the incorrect code too many times, we locked it, you know, separately, like a different way. So who's this? What up? Need the G. It's on September 30th. Okay. Cool. Bitch, you sold me water, asshole. Calm down. Bring it to me. Bringing it. Stay away. Pigs on the beach. Excuse me. Is that Frank?
Yes. This is all about Nathan trying to score for the Vortex Club party.
You home? Got the party tonight. Home. On the way. Load the bowl. It's October 4th.
Nathan was jonesing hard the night of the party. He didn't have enough drugs.
Hey, I need to score ASAP. I don't make house calls. You have a car. No time. Charge me double. Damn right. Have cash on you. No bleeping around. Give me the address. I'll call to give you the exact address. Exact directions. I in transit. Get that money out.
Drug dealer drama.
You up, bro? No shit. What you need? Peruvian flake skidoo acid. You're paying night prices. Don't make me wait. Sorry for being a dick. Need more stuff. You home? Yes. Don't come. Bleep off.
God, Nathan. You're out of control.
October 7th. Hey, need wheat, etc. Now. Calm yourself. You tweaking? Soon. Hook a brother up, please. Meet Beach. Be cool this time.
So it was you. Now I can officially call you a psycho stalker.
Yep, that's the text in our phone. Keep your smart mouth shut about everything or I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep.
No, Nathan. It's time for you to watch out. Asshole.
Hey, whore. Feminazis will be exterminated. Watch out. Shouldn't it show up in the same, like, conversation or something?
Is this from Nathan's father? That's brutal.
October 3rd. At least in any order. Please do not contact me at work. I've told you this before, and being high is not an excuse anymore. This is a business, not just a hobby. You want me to treat you like an adult who can get things done on his own? Impress me. I'd like nothing more than to be proud of you. I'm not there yet. That's it. All right.
Take a breath, Max.
Shh.
Go through all this data and you can find out where Nathan took Kate after the party.
Oh, brother. Am I just matching the dates? Kate was drinking water.
So, this infamous party was the fourth.
Okay. Ten four, get it? Select that, that's the fourth. Oh, it's the only one? Oh, just different groups? Okay, let's look at all this stuff. 10-7. Man, detective work really is drudgery.
Was Frank meeting Nathan at the junkyard?
10-3.
That beach is like Frank's main office.
Huh. 10-2, 7, and 13.
I know Nathan wasn't looking for Bigfoot in the forest.
10-1 and 10-5.
Somebody is stocking up on gas. Why?
10-4 here. As well as other dates.
If Joyce knew what Nathan did to Chloe, she would fry his ass.
No 10-4 is here.
Oh, that has to be the Prescott estate. Poor rich Nathan.
There's a 10-4 there, 6:23 p.m.
Not much out there.
10:56 p.m.
No doubt that Nathan stays in his dorm room. So he could be hiding clues there too.
Some more 10-4 there. 7:25 p.m. What's this paper say? 11 p.m. (clears throat) 10:56.
Chloe, this is definitely the place.
We got it.
Let me dig up some more clues here. Nope. Nothing, Max. There's nothing here. Just some shitty old barn.
Let's go to it.
Let's keep searching and find out who owns this haunted barn.
She might be locked up
in
there.
I'm on this. Hold on.
Tied up? Dead? In the middle of nowhere?
Somebody named Harry Aaron Prescott.
Prescott?
I'm shocked.
Bingo.
Should we call the police?
Fuck that. You know the police here are like Nathan's private security, right?
The dark room is in the barn.
That's so messed up.
As you've noticed, this whole town is messed up. We can't trust anybody, except each other. So we have to go out to that farmhouse by ourselves.
I was afraid you'd say that. We could call Warren since he kicked Nathan's ass.
It's just the two of us, nobody else. And I'm not scared at all. You have the power. I feel like we're this close to finding Rachel. We have to find her, Max.
We will. But remember, my power isn't infinite.
We still have to be careful. Do you hear, Chloe?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, if something happens to us, if we're not alive to rewind things, that's it. Plus, who knows if our power will cut out again. Well, good thing we didn't come here at night,
Wait,
at least.
Shit, this is scary.
It would be more scary.
But we're here. Let's go find the best way in.
Whoa, check this out. Fresh tire tracks.
Dude, somebody was just here.
Then we need to get in that barn. Watson, we can safely assume that this ancient vehicle is not our suspect.
Warren. I didn't realize that beating the shit out of somebody could bruise my fists. Of course, I bruised his face worse. He had that coming. That whole fight was so insane. Yes, thinking his fingers were really hurt. Yes, it so was. How are you doing? Amped up. I wouldn't want to do it again, unless I had to. You paid your hero dues. Now, we just need costumes. Speaking of, I hope you're coming to a party tonight so we can celebrate. I'll let you know, I promise. Cool, now I have to go back to striking super poses. And thanks for leaving your mark on my door. I'll never erase it. You better not, it's permanent. That's cute. I still don't know why Chloe or even Rachel would want to hang out with Frank, but I can't suss that out anymore. Maybe if I hadn't left town, I'd be less judgmental. But now we have Nathan's phone, David's coordinates, Frank's account book, and a big board of clues, which brings us closer to finding Rachel Amber. Finally. So maybe the tide is finally turning. Or time is finally turning. That's what I think I read. This is the moment where all the clues come together and we finally have a location outside of town that may lead us straight to Rachel Amber and beyond. After everything that happened with Frank, I had to convince Chloe to keep going forward with me, since I do feel we're at the end of the road. Hopefully not the end of the world, but whatever anger Chloe has inside her that makes her so destructive is matched by her balls and bravery. Yes, Chloe has gotten me nearly killed, but I know she would die for me, and I can't forget I put her in a wheelchair to slowly die in another reality. And Chloe is more focused now than before. I told her we have to keep moving forward no matter what, and I couldn't find Rachel on my own. That was enough. Now it's time to shine a light into the dark room. I don't want to go that way.
Watch us.
Fuck this bullshit.
I don't want to go that way.
Yep, see Twin Peaks. Flies. Is there a dead body in there? Electric unit?
No. Why would somebody run all that electricity into an old empty barn?
Right. Very good. Very astute.
Chloe is so damn fearless. Where does that come from? These are thick tracks and definitely fresh. Nathan's SUV?
A Oh, there's the foot of the... Oh, is that a squirrel or a bird? It's a squirrel, never mind.
Chloe,
bingo!
I found the front door! Come on!
Or the side door.
Oh, yes! Maximus rules!
I was afraid there was someone other than Chloe walking out.
God, this is way too Blair Witch. I have goosebumps all over.
All these Blair Witch references. What are the lines going to?
A little louder, Chloe. Jeez, that is ancient.
Jackpot. Old shit.
No, look closer.
Harry Aaron Prescott and family donate new library to Arcadia Bay. Prescott Industries celebrate grand opening. The Prescotts bring bomb shelter boom to town.
Nice scrapbook. You search for more clues and I'll scope out the area. Yes, old Prescott clippings. But that can't be the only thing here. Chloe would make a great detective too.
He is a great detective.
Even Harry Aaron Prescott was into selfies.
Huh. Unless he didn't take the picture and someone else did. Then that's not a selfie.
This tractor has paid its dues.
There's the tracks on the other side.
Okay, there's no reason for anybody to drive out here. But there must be. I guess the Prescotts were just born bastards.
Okay, I can't read that like that, so... 1903. Martin Lewis Prescott. Dearest Mr. Linden? I am writing in regards to your outstanding debts that you have chosen to ignore. The Prescotts may not be established business gentlemen, but we are businessmen and expect our due. We take your silence as a personal insult and thus dedicate our family name to making you pay your debt with 10% interest, plus a written apology. If these conditions are not met by the end of the day, July 24th, in the year of our Lord, 1903, rest assured we will make your life a living hell. Kindest regards, Martin Lewis Prescott. A photo of?
Wow, sir. Talk about home on the range. There's no way this rusty ass button will activate these ropes or pulleys.
Okay. Gotta be something over in that section. Pitchfork. Hook.
Scope the perimeter, Max. There has to be more here than this crate.
There's a trapdoor under there.
If a zombie shows up, I have my weapon.
Actually, it's pretty hard to fight a zombie with a pitchfork. It just sticks into the zombie and then, well, I mean, you can keep it away by holding the pitchfork.
These hooks are used to lift haystacks. I saw them in a Friday the 13th movie.
So did I, and they end up plunged into someone's back. There's a crate there. Haystack.
So many haystacks. So few needles.
I knew there was a needle thing coming up. There's a trapdoor under one of these little sections.
Ah, the good old days.
Pollard's Market. Eggs are 14 cents. Milk, 60 cents. Down there. She is down there. But you know, I can't search the other parts of the floor. We found what we needed. How do we open
this? No, Supermax. You can't open this with your bare hands.
Just about the perimeter, Max. There has to be more hidden in this crate.
You said that already, and I've found something.
Okay, Chloe. I found some kind of hatch, but it's locked. I got this. I hope. Let me know the second you need any help.
Alright, attach the hook to the lock? Yes, yes.
I should go upstairs and get Chloe to help me.
Upstairs? What are you talking about upstairs? She's supposed to say that while she's down there, isn't she?
I have to get through this monster padlock first.
Oh, platform?
The rope leads up to that platform. Must climb.
Must.
Chloe, can you give me a hand? Sidekick at your service.
She looks happy to help.
Hop up and away, Supermax.
I dig having minions.
Yeah. I dig having minions. Old motor. Pulls the old motor. Oh! Okay. I guess we wanted to do that.
That looks sturdy enough to stand on.
I thought it was like a pull type of, you know.
Tell me if you need any help.
I thought I was pulling something to, like, you know, like turn it on or prime it or something. Does she even know what we're doing, Chloe? Close to still clear over here. There's a rope.
Here's the other end of the rope.
Alright, before we attach stuff.
Please be careful up there, Max.
Let's look around some more. Oh, an owl.
Good evening, Doctor Who. Sorry.
Huh. Is this where you take a photo of its leg? Awesome.
Good evening, Doctor Who.
Huh.
Sorry.
Oh, okay. The leg is... I guess this was it? No one coming? Pull.
Nope. I can't pull this rope without tearing my flesh off. I need to hook this up to something heavier.
Do not fall.
Do not fall.
Huh? Max, use your rewind and get that motor back up there.
Okay. Thanks for the hint. I was thinking I could use that, but it's not up here anymore. Uh-huh. drop it down the other side and it'll act as a... what, a lever? Fulcrum? Whatever.
MacGyver strikes again.
I guess it didn't, fall on the trapdoor, I hope. Looks like it's next to it. Ha! Well, she's back over there. Open. Hey, hey, getting spooky,
damn,
getting scary.
This is heavy.
Rachel Amber.
What is this? Jackpot.